guys, welcome to day 5.
Good evening, Milton.
Good evening, Doctor. Still trying to save lives.
I'd like to see your goods.
Wise choice, Dr. Reid. A reliable gun is what everybody needs these days.
The patients are not fools. They know we are overwhelmed by this horrifying epidemic.
It's locked, all right. It's locked, all right. It's locked, all right.
Oh. Do you need something, Jonathan?
I have met Lady Ashbury.
She's a fascinating...
She told me you've been doing all in your power to cure her addiction.
Lady Ashbury is a cherished friend.
The matter of Lady...
Oh, I know too much about this matter already.
We'll see each other again soon. It's locked, all right. I cannot enter. The flower's dying. It needs water. It's locked.
Court medical bench.
It's locked, all right.
You must be very angry about this unfair situation. I managed to arrange to have you buried in the same grave as your wife. I hope that might help. Same mass grave as your wife. I hope that might help.
cannot enter.
I'm sorry you ended up on my plane and called medical bench, sir. I understand you must be very angry about this unfair situation. I managed to arrange to have you buried in the same mass grave as you.
It's locked.
You don't mind if I search your pockets, do you, sir? You won't need any of these anyway. I'm not stealing from you, mister. I'm only redistributing your belongings to people who need them more than you. You see, no one has claimed your body, sir, so it would be such a shame to bury you with your valuables. I will not forget you, sir. And I thank you for your generous donation. Good evening, Dr. Reid. How dare you steal from the dead, Rakesh? Is that what your pawnbrokers is really about?
These people are dead, sir. What they possessed could be useful for the living. And I'm sure they would agree if they could speak.
Whatever your motives, you're making money.
No offense, sir.
Please show me what you have.
Of course.
It's locked.
Thank you. up right now!
Over there! There's one of them!
Ah!
Watch yourselves! This one! Die, vermin!
He's too fucking fast!
Thank you. consume you. Come on. Come and face your final.
It's one of them.
This neighborhood is linked somehow to the kind Lady Ashbury's blackmail. First, let's find this Petrescu fellow. What? Shooting a boy in the middle of a street. Not the best thing to do, wouldn't you say?
What? You saw what happened. Who are you?
I'm Dr. Reid, and I'd like to ask you a few questions, if you promise me to set your gun aside.
No. Look, I'm not a violent man. I'm Benjamin Palmer, doctor. And no one can help me. Not even you.
Whatever the boy did,
I swear I didn't want to hit him.
Do you know Nurse Dorothy Crest?
Funny, I've been searching for her too.
And he's... Really? And why is that?
Word is she ain't real. It's just a cover for some...
In a miraculous cure for this unknown and deadly epidemic.
Actually...
Then you have come to the right...
Oh.
What?
Do you know...
I don't like to...
Competition.
Never met her, but it seems...
Tell me.
The region itself is...
Is there any...
Cadogan Bates, without a doubt.
What do you think?
Most of them are afraid.
I'd like to see what kind of...
Its effectiveness has been proven by many. Even the flu is no match for the swan room.
What do you want? Leave me alone.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reid. I'm looking for Nurse Dorothy Crane.
There is no Dorothy Crane here. Now, goodbye.
I'm afraid this medical leaflet says the opposite, sir.
Really? Well, I'm afraid I'm going to close this door right now. Go bother someone else, Mr. Doctor.
To enter that house, I must discover who this man really is. I must insist, sir. Please let me see Nurse Crane.
I have no time. Strange man was at the door with a pass for our medical facility. I refused him entry.
Darius, how could you know he didn't need our help?
His clothes were too finely tailored to be from Whitechapel.
Perhaps just the friend of that stray poet who is always about.
Richard Nidicott? No, not of the same cloth, this man. I suspect some machination from that journalist.
Clayton Darby? Is he still asking questions?
Yes. I saw him drifting around St. Mary's Church. I swear he is tracking me just downwind.
I must talk to that journalist or the poet. They must know about Darius. Nearby the church they just mentioned.
I cannot enter.
It's one of them!
Excuse me, sir. I have a few questions for you.
Another journalist? I didn't answer the first one, so piss off!
I'm not a journalist. I'm a doctor.
A doctor, you say? It's quite a rare...
Really?
I'm Joe Peterson to some, but Colossus Joe to most. And I don't remember asking for your service, sir.
May I ask what you...
I do whatever I want.
According to this part of town does...
Totally.
Have you heard of a...
Dorothy...
Could you please tell me more...
She's a nice girl. Tries to...
Goodbye, Mr. Peterson.
Welcome, sir. Please, take a browse of my wares.
I am Dr. Reid. I would like to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind.
Doctor? Interesting. I'm Barrett Lewis.
How is business around here?
It's no secret, Joe Peterson...
As a merchant, you see Whitechapel every day. Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary recently?
Well, you mean besides the epidemic, the war?
Violence is in...
Yeah. A few nights ago...
Where did this happen?
In the closed workshop.
Have you been hurt?
No, but that's only because I...
Have you heard of a nurse?
Nurse Crane? Is that a bit...
So she's trying to help her fellow...
Dorothy Crane ain't even a real name.
That doesn't explain why she...
Your precious Nurse Crane gives away medical supply...
Right then.
Sure.
Forgive my interruption.
Do not apologize, my son.
I am Have you any friends? Any family left?
No.
You sent-
As a true believer, Samuel will fear no evil.
Where did you send him?
I sent Samuel.
Do you know Nurse?
I don't like the liberal ideas of nurses.
So you're not-
Nuns should be the only women allowed to take care of male patients.
I have heard enough for tonight.
Excuse me, sir. Are you familiar with-
Sorry, I'm new to Whitechapel.
Dr. Reid. A famous surgeon.
I heard you're investigating an underground medical dispensary in Whitechapel. What do you know about it?
Not much, I'm afraid. They are...
I'm afraid one of the nurses from the Pembroke Hospital may be involved.
Ah! Could it be Dorothy? I don't know much about the man. He's very cautious.
He never goes out?
No. A few days ago, he unexpectedly did. I followed him, but it was just a ruse to keep me away from his house.
Really? How do you know?
He went to the nearest mailbox, but just before posting his letter, he ripped it up and threw it away.
He has no relative?
No. Except for that strange man, a poet named Richard Nithercott, who sometimes comes by. Darius would never let...
Where can I find this?
He spends most of his time lurking around White... Thank you.
Have you any idea of the danger?
I've had to run and hide more than once from frenzied mobs incensed by the fever.
That science is unable...
I can...
Why are the newspapers keeping silent about the Spanish influenza? It's as though none of you care.
There's a war going on. People shouldn't...
If no one stops it, this epidemic could turn into a scourge. It may...
Yes. This is another kind of war.
Goodbye, Mr. Darby. Farewell. The content of Darius' letter to his children could give me more leverage to enter. Good evening, miss. I'm Dr. Reid. I know what you're thinking. A talk... Melia, I know you work for Dorothy Crane. Please tell me about her secret dispensary. I know you understand what I'm saying. Very well. Goodbye then. It's locked, all right.
Ah! Ah!
This man stunned me with his faith. His crucifix. This is not good news.
Don't be shy, handsome. What can Christina do?
I'm not looking for one.
All right then, but be quick.
Tell me about yourself.
Are you joking with me? People don't usually come to see me for conversation.
I have no interest in your work. I am, however, curious as to what led you into this career.
Short story. The war, exile, and England. This country is not especially welcoming.
I always thought...
You know, this money isn't...
Do you know Nurse...
I don't know her. But I know her name is Dorothea Crăciunescu. She came from Romania like me and many others.
You seem to respect her.
Dorothea helps the sick people of Whitechapel. Everyone should respect that.
Christina, have you been examined?
I don't like doctors.
Considering your...
If...
You can put your own life in danger.
And you think that would worry me?
Goodbye, miss. Take care of yourself as best you can. Good evening, Christina.
Change your mind?
Goodbye, miss. Take care of you.
And you will all be judged for your sins. Even now, he judges your words and actions.
Ah!
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reid. I would like to ask...
Please be my guest. Although I may not be the best informant regarding this part of town, my words speak about that which...
Really? Are you...
I'm a poet, sir.
May I ask you a...
Extraordinary part of town, is it not?
What can you tell me about an old man called Darius?
Darius Petrescu? Yes, I know him. At first, I thought he was only a small publisher. I invited him to publish...
Not interested in your talent?
Darius is an old political activist who takes delight...
I'm looking for Dorothy Crane.
Dorothy Crane. Oh, I love the...
Did you know the Mute Florist is a member of a secret society?
No, I didn't. But I thank you for this information, sir. For it only enriches the mystery surrounding the precious camellia.
Are you not curious? Is there not more you wish to...
That girl has not an ounce of malice in her. Whatever she may...
Tell me, Mr. Nethercott, why seek inspiration in Whitechapel?
The place is not beautiful per se, but...
Do you not think it...
On the contrary, sir. Whitechapel is full of life, full of beauty.
What can you tell me about Camellia?
Not much. And that's the beauty of it.
Perhaps you're just afraid to find out the truth about your muse.
One day, perhaps, I'll ask her to come with me. But up.
And have you ever...
Maybe I prefer she remain...
Tell me, Mr. In what way?
The struggle by gaslight. The battle...
If you say so.
Such vibrant and...
Vivid, of course. Yes.
Oh, yes. The poignant distress.
Do you need medical attention, sir?
It may be wise to let you prescribe me something.
I understand your appetite for words and macabre.
The nutrition of my mind is more important than my physical health, but I appreciate your concern, sir.
May I ask what you're doing at this hour of...
Not at all. I'm just enjoying the pleasure.
If you say so. But as a physician in a...
Thank you.
But are you...
Oh, why should I?
Are you aware that your life...
But this is where I must be to feel the...
If some miss...
Well, you, for a start, my...
I understand... What are your thoughts on the
terrible, you say? No. Of course.
What are you talking about?
Do you remember London?
My mother loved poetry. Perhaps your words would have...
Most people fail to understand.
I'll leave you alone, sir.
Darius is a bit less of a mystery now. It should not be that difficult to incite him to let me in.
Oh, Camellia, the silent flower of Whitechapel, an angel made flesh, I tell you.
Hello again, miss. Tell me about Richard Nethercott. I understand he is quite fond of you, Camellia.
You don't seem to need my medical attention for now.
Very well.
Good evening, Christina.
Change your mind, Mr. Reid?
Do you need any assistance, Miss Popper?
It depends on...
I am shocked that you would think I...
Forgive my suspicion.
Goodbye, miss.
We even used to be neighbors, for Christ's sake.
I prefer not to give you...
You again? What do you want this time?
Can I offer you my medical expertise, Mr. Peterson?
The name is Colot.
Can I offer you my medical...
The name is Colot.
Goodbye, Mr. Peterson.
Fancy buying something, sir?
You never lose your... Do you need help, sir?
I only need you to put...
Goodbye for now, Mr. Lewis.
Stop it!
Mr. Petrescu, just 1 minute, please.
You again.
Sir, wait.
I'm nothing like you.
Yes, you are.
I have to admit, your words have come with...
Mic off.
It's locked, all right.
If you want to talk...
We've not been formed. How did you meet Nurse Crane, Darius? Why does she trust you?
I'm her oldest friend in England. Dorothea and I share many ideas about this country and about the country we left.
You mean occupied Romania, don't you? Even if not directly, I fought.
Really? Then perhaps you have more in common with Dorothy.
I know you fought for your country when it was occupied, Darius.
I know my days are numbered, and I know...
But Romania escaped...
It is not the country I fought for. My homeland is not appeased, Doctor. And I still see a dark...
Do you have any family left, Mr. Petrescu?
Who knows?
Don't be embarrassed, sir. If you must know, my own father disappeared many years ago, and I forgave him.
It's quite awkward to talk about our families like this, but... Thank you, Dr. Reid. I appreciate...
Do you need some help, Mr. Petrescu?
I am very tired, but that is all. I don't need you, Doctor.
Well, I think you do. Take this, and you'll feel better.
Free drugs from an English doctor.
Tell me everything you know.
I do not believe in the afterlife, Doctor, but I'm almost convinced Camellia is an angel. She volunteered to give out our medical...
Who is she, really? Do you know where she's from?
She's not from around here, that's all we know. Camellia is not even her name. It's her favorite flower.
You say she has no close family?
Well, there's that awful poet who constantly follows her around like a lost puppy. A good man for sure, but a very poor writer.
Are you not worried for her safety?
She is as brave as she is tough, and clever, too. If only I had met her when I was younger.
Are you in love with Camellia, Mr. Petrescu?
Don't be stupid.
So Dorothy's real name...
Like myself...
She seems important to the...
More than you can imagine. The West End...
Goodbye, Mr. Petrescu.
not thirsty! Give me a drink!
Razvan? Can you hear my voice?
What do we have here, nurse?
Patient Razvan Vasily. High fever running on 3 days. Complaints of dizziness, muscle aches, and head pain. Diagnosed with influenza.
Treatment?
Aspirin and salicin for the fever and discomfort. Liquids for dehydration, but he's having trouble keeping even water down.
Thank you, nurse. Anything else I should know?
He did lose consciousness this morning, but he's never had convulsions like these.
He's not convulsing, he's choking. He's not getting any air. Scalpel! Hand me that scalpel!
What can I do, Doctor?
It's too dangerous to operate with these convulsions. Sedative, nurse. Do we have any anesthetics?
I'm sorry, Doctor. None at all.
I need to perform a tracheostomy. Short pipe. That rubber tube will do. We're going to cut a passage for air through the neck.
Yes, Doctor. He's breathing again, but he's coughing up blood.
Internal hemorrhaging. I need to make another incision into the chest cavity to drain the fluids from the lung. Prepare another tube.
A thoracostomy? Doctor, we've nothing to fight the infection. We need an aseptic environment.
Right then, Nurse Crane. What do you suggest we do?
I've no idea. I'm not the doctor.
Time is of the essence. We need to perform a thoracic drain.
Yes, Doctor. He's still bleeding, Doctor. I'm losing his pulse.
The drain must have punctured the intercostal artery. There's too much blood.
Are you all right, Doctor?
I can't see. I must first suture the artery. Find the wound. The source of the blood.
Needle and thread, Doctor.
Good. The stitches are holding. How's he doing?
We're losing him. We've lost his pulse. He's dying, Doctor!
Cardiac massage, now.
Cardiac... what? Are you making this up as you go along? We've lost the pulse. He's gone, Doctor.
Nurse, we did everything we could.
Truly? Everything you could? Is that how you'll report this in your log? Is this how the war went? Piling up one poor corpse beside the next?
This was not an influenza-induced seizure. I've never seen symptoms like these on the continent.
Neither have I. But the previous symptoms leading up to this attack were the same, indistinguishable from the epidemic.
No. There was something more vile in these reactions. Something primitive.
There have been numerous reports of mental breakdowns caused by the fever that accompanies the flu itself, Doctor.
Yes, but... I'd best take some samples of the blood for analysis.
I doubt you're here to test my bedside manners. To what do I owe this courtesy?
It's locked, all right.
I suspect it was more than intuition alone that led you to us. So, how might I be of service, Dr. Reid?
I've come to put an end to this insufferable blackmailing, Dorothy.
Doctor, you think your warnings scare me? I've stolen and plied, blackmailed and lied, but what else am I to do? I'm all these people have.
You've convinced me of the sincerity of your actions and their noble justifications. But all the same, blackmail is a crime, and it will stop, Nurse Crane.
So... are you going to turn me over to the authorities?
Nurse Crane, there is no question that the work you've done here is extraordinary, but this dispensary is incapable of coping with the outbreak. It's only a question of days before the situation at hand will overwhelm us. I cannot allow it. It's my duty to put an end to this immediately.
I did what was right. For in the end, I saved lives and you took them. But we had so much in common, Doctor. Don't you see that?
Am I gone?
Hello, Mr. Petrescu.
Hello, Dr. Reid. Come on in. Yes? Dorothea helping our comrades now that I die.
When science fails you, this elixir.